I came to write Invisible Man as a result of a failure. I had conceived of a novel during the time I was going to sea during the Second World War. I was working as a second cook and baker on merchant ships. But somehow the Rosenwald Fund had granted me a fellowship to work on a novel, and I had a novel. It was a wartime novel wherein I had a Negro flyer. We were very excited by the fact that Negroes were flying planes during that war, but also concerned that they weren't being allowed into combat as rapidly as some of us thought so. But anyway, I conceived of this book wherein a Negro flyer comes down, is captured by the Nazis, and is placed in a detention camp where he is the highest ranking officer. You can see how how my mind was working. He was the highest ranking American, and you had the Nazi who was philosophically minded and who pitted this American against the other Americans. Well, going into Le Havre on that particular trip to sea when I was working on this book, it turned out to be such a hot passage that I came back to the States with a blood pressure of about 90 and absolutely through with that particular idea. The emotional organization and everything was just out of it. But one thing led to another. I was somewhat ill, and the Merchant Marine Hospital people told me to get a rest. And I went to a friend's place at Waitsfield, Vermont. And while there, certain things that I'd been doing, reading, thinking about, came into focus. It's sort of unconscious focus, as often happens when you're writing something. I had been reading Lord Raglan's The Hero, and thinking about the question of the mythological leader and how historical figures take on his mythic attributes as they become prominent. And I was thinking about fact that Negro leaders at that time seldom really led Negroes, but were usually dependent upon the largesse of white supporters, that they had no particular way in affecting their will. And I was, of course, concerned with literary problems and with a number of other intellectual things, which I can't go into now. But while there, one morning, scribbling, I wrote the first sentence of what later became Invisible Man. I'm an invisible man. And I played with that, started to reject it, but it intrigued me, and I began to put other things with it. And pretty soon, I had a novel going. I began to work out a conceptual outline of it, and as fast as I could work out the concepts, the incidents started flowing in on me.